Hello everyone, welcome back. As I already said you in the previous video, we'll be learning about types of synthetic fibers and their characteristics in this video, right? So let's get started. And in this video we are going to learn about rayon, nylon, polyester and acrylic, and also about what are the characteristics of synthetic fibers. Okay, why we have to prefer them, or what are the advantages of synthetic fibers and what are the disadvantages of synthetic fibers. Clear? So the first synthetic fiber about which we are going to learn is rayon. Okay, rayon is also called as artificial silk. Why rayon is called as artificial silk, we'll be learning, you'll be coming to know at the end of this topic. Okay, actually you know about silk, right? Silk is a natural fiber. It is made up of silkworm, and rearing of silkworm is called as sericulture. I hope you learned about this in your 7th grade. So rayon is made up of, sorry, not rayon, actually we get silk from silkworm, but rearing of silk from silkworm and manufacturing pure silk is very costly process, so that everybody cannot afford. So in that case the rayon has come into picture. It is an artificial fiber that is similar to silk. It is almost similar to silk. Many scientists have tried a lot to discover a substitute for silk so that everybody can buy silk easily, because a pure silk is very costly and everybody cannot buy that. So at the end of the 19th century, almost at the end of the 19th century, we have obtained rayon, which is an artificial fiber that is similar to silk, that its appearance is similar to silk. So that is the reason why rayon is called as the artificial silk. Okay, clear now? So it is discovered in the end of the 19th century. This is also clear. This point also clear, right? Next, it is obtained by chemical treatment of wood pulp. Actually, it is obtained by the chemical treatment of a substance which is called as the wood pulp. But this wood pulp is a natural source, right? Wood pulp. You know what is an wood pulp? So wood pulp is actually a natural resource. So that when it is a natural source, why does rayon come into the category of synthetic fibers? You may get a doubt. Right? Why it will not come into the category of natural fibers? But for your clarity, let me tell you, it is obtained by the chemical treatment of wood pulp. We are not directly getting it from the wood pulp. By adding some chemicals to the wood pulp, we are getting rayon. So that is the reason why rayon is an artificial silk. Okay? Rayon is an artificial fiber. Okay? And what is the advantage of rayon than silk over silk? That means it is cheaper than silk. So the cost of rayon is less when compared to the cost of silk, and it can be weaved similar to the silk fibers. How silk looks like, in the same way you can also make rayon to look in the same way. So that is the reason why rayon is having very much popularity. Okay, and it can be dyed in wide variety of colors. Dyeing is nothing but, the word dyeing means adding color to the cloth, or adding color is called as dyeing. So you can add different types of colors to the rayon cloth, and you can obtain a cloth in different ways. So when you mix this rayon with cotton, you can make bed sheets out of it, and when you mix this rayon with wool, you can make carpets out of it. Clear? Rayon is called as artificial silk. It is called as artificial silk because it is almost similar to silk. It looks like silk, but it is made by man. So that is the reason why it is called as artificial silk. And it is discovered in the end of the 19th century, and it is obtained by the chemical treatment of wood pulp. This point is very much important. That is the reason why I have written it in different ink. Okay. Obtained by the chemical treatment of wood pulp. Clear? The next, it is cheaper than silk. This is about rayon. Clear? So then after rayon, the another synthetic fiber we are going to learn about is nylon. Okay. So how do you make nylon? Nylon is, you don't use any natural fiber, like natural raw material, in the sense you will not use cotton, or you will not use wool, or you will not use silk. You will not use any of the natural fibers in order to make rayon. Okay, so that is the reason why it is a first fully synthetic fiber. That means everything is made up of different materials other than these natural fibers. So that is the reason why it is a first fully synthetic fiber. Okay, it is prepared from coal, water, air. Remember this point, okay, very clearly. I am putting stars. Prepared from coal, water and air. So nylon is prepared in the year, it was invented in the year 1931. It is prepared from coal, water, air. Here we are not using any of the natural fiber, so that is the reason why it is called as the first fully synthetic fiber. Clear? And what are the characteristics of nylon? It is very strong. Nylon cloth is very strong. It is elastic. That means you can expand it, and it is light in weight. Okay, it is easy to carry. Clear? These are the characteristics of nylon. Okay, and some more characteristics of nylon are, this nylon cloths can be washed easily. So as it is easy to wash, it became very popular because people will prefer to do a less work, to do work efficiently, right? If you have to sit for hours and hours together to wash clothes, it is of time waste. So that is the reason why people will choose to go for nylon. And what are the other things that you can make from nylon? As we have seen, from rayon we can make bed sheets, carpets and all. From nylon we can make socks, ropes, tents, toothbrushes, seat belts, curtains, etc. But the thing is, nylon is very stronger than a steel wire. So nylon is used in making ropes and all those things. And even seat belts in our car are also very strong because they are made up of nylon. They will be long lasting for many years because they are made up of nylon, and nylon is a very strong synthetic fiber. How strong it is means you can even use it in making parachutes also. Parachute is it has to carry the weight of a person, a weight of a 50 kg person or a 25 kg person or a 100 kg weight it has to carry. So it is made up of nylon. Nylon is that much strong that it can carry that much of heavy weight also. So that is the reason why nylon is used in making parachutes and also ropes for rock climbing. When you climb, you will be having ropes, and that rope will balance your weight. So that means the rope should be very much strong. If you use a rope which is made up of plastic or which is made up of a simple cloth, it cannot balance the heavy weight. So in order to avoid that problem, we are using nylon for making the ropes and also parachutes. Clear? Next synthetic fiber we are going to learn is polyester and acrylic. Okay, first let us learn about polyester and then we will go for acrylic. Okay, they do not wrinkle easily. Wrinkle is nothing but the cloth will become very untidy, like you have to iron it always. So if you don't have time for ironing your cloths, in that case you can opt for polyester cloths. Okay, and they remain crisp and easy to wash. Crisp is nothing but they are always stiff. They are always, you will not find any wrinkles on them. So, and you can also easily wash. And terlin is most popular polyester that you can see. Okay, and PET is a type of a polyester. It is also a type of polyester. PET bottles, PET wires, maybe you have learned it, maybe you have heard it somewhere. So PET is a substance. It is also one type of polyester. Terlin is also one type of polyester, and this is used in making bottles, utensils, wires, etc. Clear? And now coming to the origin of the word polyester, how did you get the word polyester? Poly plus ester, right? Polyester means poly plus ester. Ester is a chemical substance. It is a chemical substance. About ester, you'll be learning in your higher classes. Most probably, you'll be learning it in your 10th class, or if you are in your IIT foundation, then you'll be learning it in your 9th grade itself. So ester is one of the chemical substance, and when you combine so many molecules of ester together, you will be getting the polyester. Okay, you'll be getting this polyester. It is also a type of a polymer only. Okay, I said about polymer in the last video. Polymer is nothing but you will be combining all small chemical substances in order to form a very big large chemical substance. Clear? And from polyester you can make polycot, polywool, etc. Polycot is a combination of polyester and cotton. This cot means cotton. Polyester, cotton, and polywool is a combination of polyester and wool. So there are the different types of polyesters. What are the different types of polyesters? We have learnt now. Terlin is one of them, PET is one of them, polycot, polywool. There are many other types of polyesters, okay? But the disadvantage of polyester is it will catch fire easily. So that is the reason why it is suggested not to wear polyester clothes in the kitchen. Clear? When you are working in the kitchen or when you are doing something near to fire, you are not suggested to wear polyester clothes. Even when you are firing crackers on Diwali, so you should not wear polyester clothes because polyester can catch fire easily. Okay, not only polyester, all the synthetic fibers will catch fire easily. Okay, that is a disadvantage we have about synthetic fibers. Okay, we'll be learning it later on. So next is acrylic. The next synthetic fiber we are going to learn about is acrylic. So acrylic is a substitute for wool. Okay, natural wool. It is a substitute for natural wool. Natural wool is very expensive because it is made from the skin of the sheep. Right, we have to take out the skin of the sheep and we have to culture in the sense we have to process it. We have to do a lot of process in order to get wool from the skin of the sheep. So that is the reason why natural wool is very expensive and you cannot roughly use it. So you should be very delicate about it and all. So in order to replace natural wool, we got another synthetic fiber, that is acrylic. Okay, so it is also similar to wool. This acrylic is used in making sweaters and shawls and caps, many things you can make out of acrylic. Whatever the things that you can make by using wool, those things you can make by using acrylic also. Okay, and these acrylic clothes or acrylic materials are more durable in the sense you can use them for longer time. They will be giving service for longer time without getting damaged. That means you can use them for 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, 10 years. Okay, and it is more affordable. That means the cost is also less when compared to the natural wool. Everybody cannot afford, so but acrylic everybody can afford. Okay, the next last concept of this video is characteristics of synthetic fibers. So what are the characteristics of synthetic fibers and why we should use synthetic fibers instead of natural fibers? They can dry easily. When you wash your clothes and when you dry them on the rope, they will dry faster when compared to the natural fibers. Clear? They are durable. That means you can use them for a longer time and cheap. They are lesser expensive when compared to natural fibers. They are not so much cheap, but when compared to natural fibers, they are cheap. Okay, next, readily available. That means you can get them anywhere. Okay, they are easily available in almost of all the stores and all the malls, and they are easy to maintain. You can maintain them easily. That means always ironing or always applying starch, all those things are not mandatory for these type of synthetic fibers. And you have a very big disadvantage of this synthetic fibers, that is they can catch fire easily because they are made of petrochemicals. Okay, petrochemicals, and these petrochemicals are made up of petroleum. Petroleum is a fuel. It will catch fire easily. So that is the reason why, as it is made up of petroleum, these petrochemicals are used in making synthetic fibers. These petrochemicals are used in almost every synthetic fiber. So that is the reason why they will catch fire easily. That is the only disadvantage we have with the synthetic fibers. Clear? So now with this video, we have completed the topic synthetic fibers in the chapter 3. In the next video, we'll be moving on to the plastics. What are plastics? What are thermosetting? What are the thermoplastic? And what are the disadvantages of plastic? Advantages? Everything you'll be learning in the next video related to plastics. Clear? If you have any doubts in this video, let me know in the comments. I'll reply to each and every comment. I'll clarify each and everyone's doubts. You need not worry about that. And if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, do subscribe and share with your friends. If you have understood whatever I've explained in this video clearly, hit the like button and don't forget to share with your friends. If you want me to include any other topics or any other subjects or any other chapters, let me know in the comments. I'll do it for you. And If you have missed the previous videos of this playlist of this grade 8 science, I'll give you the link of the playlist in the description. You can go back, check, and you can watch those videos. And I'll give you the link of the WhatsApp group also in the description. You can join the group using the link and you can ask me any doubts. I'll clarify all your doubts at any time, any notes or any PDF you can ask me there. I'll give you for sure at any time at free of cost. Okay, you need not worry about that. Thanks for watching this video, and guys, don't forget to share with your friends. Okay, thank you.